Now, after creating all these different parts, we will create an assembly. To create a new assembly file, we need to click on this plus and physical product, or can go to this if we compose, select the application assembly design, we'll give the title. Click OK. So this is assembly design application. Now one by one we'll go on inserting the different components. Insert existing 3D part into this assembly. Bottom plate, this part. The first component which we'll insert, for that we need to give the fix as the constraint so that it will be fixed. Now we'll insert the another component, insert existing 3D part, where in this quad frame assembly we can search in this search window as well, or if the part is open we can select graphically as well this way, so that this will put in our assembly. Then we need to give the different engineering connection. Then we need to give different engineering connections. Engineering connections are nothing but the constraints, assembly constraints. These are the different types of engineering connections available. These types of joints like rigid, spherical, cylindrical, planar, prismatic, revolute, screw. All these different types of complex joints like gear, rack, cable, all these types of joints also available. To create these type of joints, we need to select the appropriate elements for the constraint. Now this axis of the hole and the corresponding axis of the another part's hole. Immediately it will put the component align with respect to the given constraints. So axis of both the components are aligned, coincident. One more axis and the corresponding axis of the other component's axis. These two constraints are created, coincidence constraints. Then one more constraint, that is the face, and another face of the mating component. So automatically it has created a rigid joint between the front arm and this bottom plate. Click OK. So new engineering connection is created.